So I'm very happy to be here at Mozilla with Brendan Eich, the CTO of Mozilla, and the designer of JavaScript. I was wondering if you could tell us a bit about how that language came to be.
Sure. So I could say more about how I got ready to make JavaScript, because when I arrived at Netscape, I didn't have much time to do it, and I had to have the skills already. And I've been interested in writing programming language implementations for my entire career. When I got into computer science, it was from physics, and it was first by studying the theory of formal languages and automata theory, regular languages, regular expressions. This was in the early 80s, and I loved the cleanliness of the theory and the rather direct way of implementing a lot of the theory as algorithms, so that you could make a parser or a lexer semi-automatically or automatically. This was very interesting to me, and it was useful too. I think every practicing programmer should take time to invent a language at some point. There's often a need you have that no particular language is perfect for, or you have some leisure time and you can use that. It's educational and it can often solve your problem better than any other language. And so I encourage that, and I did that myself throughout my career, and that sort of helped me get ready to do JavaScript. Because when I got to Netscape and the heat of the moment was there with Java looming and questions about whether we need two languages, a scripting language versus a big language like Java, I had to go fast. So I had to have it all sort of in my muscles. I had to have some practice already under my fingers.
So in this class, we will learn a lot of the things that he just mentioned at various points. Regular expressions, finite state machines, having a lexer fall out of that automatically, context-free grammars, parsing, having a parser fall out of that automatically. And I can only say that I really agree. I've written a number of little languages in my time to scratch various itches, and I think it's a really important tool to have under one's belt.